Okay, let's look at the shell of these HMDs. The Rift is a mortarboard. Pretty simple. The DK2 though seems to come with its own armament, which adds bulk. So the front aspect looks thinner, smaller even, when you compare it to the mortarboard of DK1. DK2 is actually bulkier and heavier, which again is an interesting development, because you'd expect second iterations of HMDs to be lighter, smaller, and less bulky. So there must be some pretty significant reason for having this level of armament on the outside, and I don't think it's a fashion decision. But that kind of bulk really changes the ergonomics of a device. Unless it's absolutely vital, it really shouldn't be there. Your Google Cardboard or your phone VR device that you can 3D print can have a better display than this, cost less, and way less. Please discuss, Mr. Carmack. Plus side, there's less Muppet on this device, or feels like there's less Muppet on this device. And of course the display is so much better. But it's still interesting. Some of the decisions they made designing this, completely discarded. Making this, which makes you wonder, is DK3 going to be heavier and bulkier than this one? So at the moment, if you're a PC gamer developer with a giant rig that sits under your desk, this breakout box can be an issue. Whereas this one gave you acres of room. This also suggests that they don't trust your HDMI lead choice. But this doesn't feel as tough as this. Positional tracker linked with this cable to the breakout box and your HMD. Now again, because of the short length of this and the need to have this at the back of your PC and this on your monitor, it means you are tethered to your desktop. Unless you put this on a tripod, carry it with you. Now, can this compete with Kinect 2 for PC, and other positional trackers for the PC, which don't need you to be tethered to the HMD? like this one does. That's something I'll be testing. The other thing to realize is when you start this, you may see no display whatsoever. You need to download a firmware, update the firmware on the Rift before you can use it, and set the display mode to desktop mode to be sure you get a display. Something I'll cover in another video. But this level of wiring, it's not really evolutionary when HMDs are starting to look like this. And it's a matter of time before this starts to do what this does, and more. In fact, you could already make it do some of these things. One of the big questions when looking at DK2 use for me is going to be, has it evolved or devolved from DK1?